Weather here in Hampton Roads.
So many people have grown up watching him.
Can say for certain if a storm will hit the area in the next 10 weeks.
1990, the year we launched the Hubble telescope into orbit.
2, 1, and lift off.
Wilson Phillips, Hold On, topped the charts. And a young Penn State grad named Jeff Lawson would make his first appearance on air here at 13 News Now.
In Norfolk, Jeff Lawson, 13 News.
It was just clear from the very beginning that he was a super smart guy.
Jeff came into WVEC and made the weather department his own.
His forecasting philosophy, deeply scientific, but simple. Get it right, don't overhype. Jeff found his passion early in life, spending time forecasting across the state before landing here at WVEC.
I first met Jeff back in 1997. We both at the time had children that were born about the same time.
Jeff isn't just a forecaster, he's a friend.
Yeah, things are definitely easing up, no doubt about that.
Over the years, Jeff's audience of fans would grow. His legendary four-decade career, an inspiration to viewers, weather watchers, and future forecasters.
Meeting Jeff for the first time is a little intimidating
because he's just a giant in this industry.
Good evening. If you've been outside lately, you know.
But fame is not something this chief meteorologist ever basks in. For Jeff, the weather and keeping our region safe from the worst of it has always been the focus.
His leadership and guidance as a forecaster and as a chief, it was really remarkable. What people may or may not know about Jeff, he's hilarious.
So there is a blooper of Jeff. He's doing weather.
The last two or three.
And there were these incandescent lights. It got hot in the studio.
It should come to a halt and try to re. Oh my God, we have a fire in the studio, but if we can keep going here.
And the first thing is, you can tell is he's like, do I stay or do I go?
I know, he has too many stories.
That signature smile you may have spotted out on the roads. Jeff's cycling career, nearly as prolific as his forecasting.
All game forecast, Jeff.
All of it, we're going to miss.
One word I would use to describe Jeff is conscientious.
Purposeful.
Stability.
Professional.
Intellectual. That's actually one of my favorite words.
One of my best friends on the planet. You bring such passion to meteorology and life in general. Best of luck.
Will forever be a part of the history of the station.
Congrats, Jeff. We're gonna miss you.
To the man who's devoted his life to accuracy, enjoy a well-deserved retirement. Because getting it right is exactly what this station did 33 years ago.
Yeah. Oh, wonderful.
That's the truth.
Did you like that one where I had the mustache for a while?
Yeah, you looked, you know what? You looked the same.
A little.
Yeah, wow, 30-something years. I mean, just the impact that you have had on this community, it just cannot be summed up in words.
Oh, thanks. I've loved every minute of it.
Mm-hmm.
At times, you know, it's frustrating, but overall, it's been absolutely wonderful. So let's do it one last time.
One more time.
And so far, I've held it together. We'll see if I still do when I have to read my going away coming up in just a minute. But let's start here with the actual forecast, and as you can see, we're talking about a low pressure area down to the south. Talked earlier, you have that sort of comma shape that indicates a fairly mature storm. There are actually significant flood events expected across southern areas there of Florida, down near Miami, up toward Palm Beach. The storm's going to ride here off the shoreline and stay well offshore. But the question is it, 100 miles offshore, 150, because that back edge is going to come very, very close to us. We see that a lot with winter storms. Right now, 54 degrees, but no wind. The wind has gone calm. Humidity, not bad, 69%. So tonight, down to about 46 or so, a little colder inland, maybe some low 40s or even near 40, very rural locations, otherwise partly cloudy. Winds very light out of the south and southwest. So the high today, I mentioned earlier, 1 degree warmer than yesterday. Typically we're at 62. Yesterday was 59. Today was 60. And last night's low, second night in a row, I went 43, it was 41. Night before, it was even more below the forecast. We've been having the cold night, and it was actually a lot colder than that again for the inland areas. Highs today, very much. I could show yesterday's map, and you wouldn't notice any difference. And this is then very similar through the evening and into the overnight. temperatures drop back through the 40s and eventually very inland areas, as I said, maybe even upper 30s. Most of us, I think, will be around 40, and with the wind off the water, won't be much of a wind. It'll probably stay, you know, 42, 43, something like that. Tomorrow, though, we start to trend up. 66, decent amount of sunshine, not dim sunshine like we had at times today. We stay through Thursday evening, very temperate, and then here comes some of that storminess from the coastline sitting offshore, and by Friday afternoon, working its way up through the Outer Banks. By Friday evening, cutting right across our area. If you live north and west, you have much, much lower rain odds than you do if you're south and east. And right here in Hampton Roads, sort of, you know, south side of the metro area, it literally could go either way. It's up in the air, no pun intended, even though I'm known as the king of the puns in the, you know, among my compatriots. As you can see, Saturday morning, very temperate as well. And then we're going to clear out. This is an area, believe it or not, of possible tropical development, about a 50% chance. It's not going to affect us. It'll stay well offshore. But the one sliding across that I just pointed out has about a 10% chance of becoming sort of a hybrid system as it gets east of Hatteras. So tonight, 46, a little colder inland, maybe upper 30s in some of the coldest areas under partly cloudy skies. Tomorrow, mostly sunny early and then partly sunny later again and much milder. Tomorrow night, 54, chilly, but calm. That's a lot better than the 30s we've seen. And then look at the 7-day forecast. Some North Carolina showers possible by Friday afternoon, and then Friday night, I think we'll have some here in Hampton Roads, especially near the coast. And then it looks like it'll all be gone, I think, by early Saturday. A little chillier Sunday and Monday, and then some more rain moves in next Tuesday and Wednesday.
Jeff, thank you. And we've shared some of our favorite memories of Jeff. Now it's time for him to say goodbye to you. He'll share his final message to the community next.
Well, it's finally that time. 43 years ago when I started my career, I never could imagine that I'd end up here. I started out forecasting, believe it or not, for private clients like Newport News Shipbuilding and 2WD Radio. 3 years later, said, you know, let's give TV a try. And last week, like last Tuesday, marked 40 years since I started in Richmond. Then it was on to Channel 5 in DC, and it was there that I met my new fiance, now wife, Denise, and she said, you know, let's move back to my hometown. Many decades later, I am thankful that my bosses gave me so much support, including the freedom to make my own, quote, out on a limb forecast that I became known for. I had some chances to leave, some for bigger cities, some here in town. It just never felt right. It's amazing how this station and this community have become home. My kids, who are standing over there, grew up here. They'd hide like right under this desk while I was talking to you. They'd draw pictures with an electronic pencil. Once, a picture of Sandra Parker showed up on the air with a fake mustache and a beard. I'll never forget that. I was worried I might get fired. Also, I'd already been here 14 years when my son brought home a friend he met on the bus in sixth grade. I've been here so long that that little kid is now my co-anchor, Connor Reel, sitting right over there. I've also made some of my best friends here, Scott Cash, David Allen, Joe Flanagan, my fellow meteorologists, my fellow anchors like Janet, Nicole, Dan, Brian, hope I didn't leave anybody out, and others from behind the scenes who you don't even know. So thank you so much for letting me into your homes all these years. Thanks for being so supportive through the tough times, like when I had part of my tongue removed twice for cancer, as well as celebrating the good times. I've gotten to meet thousands of you, and I hope you'll continue to say hi if you see me out and about. But I leave you in good hands. Tim is already doing a wonderful job replacing me. And of course, I can't forget Craig and Evan with 50 combined years of experience between them just here at 13 News Now. I know they'll continue along with Tim to provide the best forecasts in the market. And while Francis and Taylor might not have 50 years of experience, they are very talented and do a great job as well. So thank you, and I will see you around town.
Wonderful job, Jeff.
Bravo,
man, we are going
bravo.
To miss you around here.
Yes, we're going to miss you. We're going to miss you. But thank you so much for everything you've done for the station and everything you have done for the entire Hampton Roads community.
I appreciate it. It's been an honor.
Yes, and really a beautiful family. Yeah,
no, thank you.
And look, Scott Cash is here. All right. Thank you so much for joining us and have a wonderful evening.
Thank you, Jeff Lawson, for an amazing 33-year run.